Assalamu alaikum dear students, I am your instructor Salman Amin Malik for the course Linear Algebra, and today we have the fourth lecture of Linear Algebra. Let me recall you some of the ideas which we have discussed in the third lecture. In the third lecture we have discussed one of the basic and important concept of Linear Algebra, which was the linear combination of given vectors and span of given vectors. What was the span? Span was the collection of all linear combinations of given vectors. Suppose you are given three different vectors from the space R3, then the span of these three vectors is a set which contains all possible linear combinations of the given three vectors. How many linear combinations are there of one or more than one vectors from a given space? Of course, we have discussed that there are infinite many different linear combinations. So, span contains all linear combinations of given vectors from a certain space, R3, space could be R3, R4, Rn. So, span contains infinite many elements as a form of linear combinations of a given vectors. फिर हमने ये भी डिस्कस किया था कि फॉर अ गिवन वेक्टर, अगर आपको कोई गिवन वेक्टर दिया गया हो तो वो गिवन वेक्टर्स v1, v2, v3 सपोज उसके स्पैन में कब होगा. इट रिक्वायर्स द सॉल्यूशन ऑफ द सिस्टम ऑफ लीनियर इक्वेशन, एंड एट द एंड आई हैव गिवन सम ऑफ द प्रैक्टिस प्रॉब्लम. एज यूजुअल आई विल स्टार्ट माई लेक्चर फ्रॉम द practice problem. So let's go to the slide and see what is the practice problem. Today we have the lecture number 4. So the first practice problem which we have discussed in the last lecture is here. Let A be this matrix and B is given by this vector. The question asked is B in the span of columns of A? What does it mean? It means that if we consider these vectors, the columns of the vectors as matrix, as a vectors, let's say A1, A2, A3, then we can talk about the span of A1, A2 and A3, which in fact is a set which contains all linear combinations of A1, A2 and A3. That is C1, A1 plus C2, A2 plus C3, A3. And C1, C2, C3 are the real numbers. So span of any vectors, we have learned in the last lecture that span of given vectors is in fact a linear, all linear combinations of this form, where C1, C2, C3 are real numbers. So we are given a vector B. We have to check whether B belongs to this span or not. B will be in this set if this vector equation has a solution. C1 A1 plus C2 A2 plus C3 A3 equals B. This vector equation has a solution. And this vector equation has the augmented matrix as 2, minus 1, 1, 0, 8, minus 2, 6, 5, and 1. And of course, the right hand side of this vector equation is 10, 10, 3, and 7. And we have to solve the system of linear equation corresponding to this vector equation and whose augmented matrix is this one. Whose augmented matrix is this one. So first row operation, we will get the echelon form of this augmented matrix. So first row operation will be that I am going to interchange the third and first row. So the third row, which is 1, minus 2, 1, 7, will become my first row. The second row remains as it is, 8, 5, and 3. And my third row becomes the first row, jo ke yahan pe thi, 2, 0, 6, and 10. Theek hai? Now, this is the pivot element. I have to make these two elements as 0. So, I will do the row operations, that is R2 plus R1 and R3 minus 2 times R1. And my matrix is row equivalent to 1, minus 2, 1, 7, 0. I have to just add, here I will have 6, here I will have 6, here I will have 10. I have to subtract 2 times to make this one as 0. So I will subtract, do the row operation, minus 2 times R1. That will make here 4, and that will make here 4, and I have here 10, and 10 minus 14, that is minus 4. So pivot is this one. So first I will make it as 1, 1, 0, 0 by dividing the complete row by 6. So I will have 10 by 6, which is equals 5 by 3, and I have here 4, 4, and minus 4. And the row operation I did 1 by 6, R2. Next, I have to make this entry as 0. So I do the row operation as R3 minus 4 times R2. So that will become 1, minus 2, 1, 7, 0, 1, 1, 5 by 3, and here I will have 0, 0, 0, minus 4, and minus 20 by 3, 5 times. This is, of course, a non-zero number. And we know that if our augmented matrix has a row which is all entries 0 and one non-zero number, then the system is inconsistent. So this system, which corresponds to the linear combination of the columns of A written equals B, the given vector B, has no solution. This system of linear equation has no solution. It means that we are not able to find C1, C2, and C3 such that this vector equation holds. It means that B cannot be written as a linear combination of columns of A, or it's the same thing as B does not belong to span of A1, A2, A3. Okay. Now the second part of the question is show that the second column of A is in the span of columns of A. Now the second column A2 can be written as C1. I can take C1 equals 0, A1, plus C2 I can take 1 into A2, plus C3 0, A3. So I am having A2 equals A2, the column A2 which is here. We are able to write one column A2 in terms of linear combination of the other columns, A1, A2, and A3. In fact, every column can be written as a linear combination of these columns by taking C1 equals 0 corresponding to the other columns and taking 1 corresponding to the that column. For example, here the column number 2, so I take C2 equals 1 and all other entries are 0. So that is how we can also show that A1 is in the span of the columns of A. So A1, column A1 could be equals 1, A1 can be written as 0 into A2 plus 0 into A3. So these will be 0 and ultimately we have A1 equals A1. So every vector correspond to the span, whereas we are looking for the span of the given vectors, every vector belonging to the vector belongs to the span also. ठीक है, ये इस एग्जाम्पल में हमने जो है शो करना था कि सेकेंड कॉलम जो है स्पैन में है, इनफैक्ट फर्स्ट कॉलम भी स्पैन में है, इनफैक्ट थर्ड कॉलम भी स्पैन में है. इनफैक्ट आपको जितने भी वैक्टर्स दिए गए हों तो एवरी वैक्टर इज इन द स्पैन ऑफ दीज वैक्टर्स. ठीक है, इन टूडेज लेक्चर वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस द मैट्रिक्स इक्वेशन व्हाट वी कॉल AX इक्वल्स बी. ए इज अ मैट्रिक्स गिवन, एक्स are the unknowns and B is a vector from certain space. Of course, we have to justify that AX could be multiplied in terms of the matrix multiplication. So A is an M into N matrix with columns A1, A2, AN, and if X belongs to RN, why here we have RN? Because we know that the matrix multiplication is possible whenever the number of columns of first matrix A matrix equals the number of rows of the second matrix, which is the column matrix. So that's why we have here N. Then the product of A and X denoted by AX is the linear combination of the columns of A using the corresponding entries in X as weights. AX, the matrix product, is defined. A can be written as, where A1, A2 up to so on, AN are the columns of the matrix A, and each vector A1 has M entries, and we have the element of RN. We multiply this one. This one is the matrix equation, this one, and this one is the vector equation we have learned in the last lecture. So matrix multiplication in fact is corresponding to a vector equation, where x1 is this, the first component of the vector from Rn, x2 is the second component of the vector from Rn, so on and so forth, xn is the last component of the vector of Rn. So we have written the matrix equation or matrix multiplication as a vector equation, and vector equation we have discussed already. A remark, AX is defined only if the number of columns of A equals the number of entries in X. Of course, the matrix multiplication is only possible when the number of columns of A equals the number of rows of X. That's why we are having from an element from Rn, and this is the matrix of order M into N. Let's go to the next slide. For example, here I gave you some examples. This is a matrix. This is a matrix of order 2 by 3. So from which space we will take a vector to multiply to define the term A, X? Of course, X should be the number of columns, should be equals the number of rows, and it is a vector, so it is from the space R3. So, ये हमारा R3 में से वेक्टर है और ये मैट्रिक्स है. We want to calculate the matrix product or the matrix equation. So, we have 4, the x1 into the first column here. The second entry of the vector, second column. Second entry and second column. Third entry of the vector and third column. We multiply and add, and this is the ultimate answer. Of course, you can have the same answer by matrix multiplication. You can check that. In example number 2, we have a matrix whose order is 3 by 2. So, from which space we should have a vector? Of course, we should have a vector from R2, which has 2 rows and 1 column, because it is a vector. So, this vector belongs to R2. by defining the AX, the matrix multiplication AX, which we have learned in this lecture, is in fact the vector equation, the first entry, 4 into the first column. This is the first column, the second entry, and the second column. And ultimately, we multiply and add these two matrix, we have this as a solution. For given vectors in Rm, the next example is we are given three different vectors, v1, v2, v3, which are from the space Rm. It means that v1 has order m into 1 as well as v2 and v3. Write the linear combination. This is the linear combination. So the answer of this linear combination will always be a vector in Rm as a matrix times a vector. We have to write down this linear combination, which is I am writing here 3v1 minus 5v2 plus 7v3 as a matrix multiplication A into some vector x. Now we just learned that v1 and v2, v3 could be the columns of the matrix A. So our matrix columns are v1, v2, and v3. And the vector, the number of columns are 3. So our vector by which we multiply this matrix and we got this linear combination is, as in the previous examples, we have the first entry with the first column. So the first entry will be 3. The second entry will be minus 5. The third entry will be 7. So this is the matrix A defined by this one, and this is the matrix X, such that your linear combination given can be written as matrix multiplication. So this is very important. And in the next example, write the system of linear equation in the matrix form AX equals B. From this system of linear equation, we can easily have the matrix A, which is the coefficients of the variables x1 and x2. I have already told you in my previous lecture. Maine apne previous lectures mein bhi aapko bata diya. x2 ka coefficient second column hota hai. Apne system mein first equation mein -1 hai, second equation mein 3 hai. x3 ka coefficient jo hai, that in the system, that will make or constitute the third column of your matrix, that will be 1 and 2. So this is your matrix, and of course its order is, it has 2 rows and 3 columns. So we can multiply this matrix with a vector which has order 3 into 1, because it is a vector, that's why it has only one column. So it will be, it should be x1, x2, and x3. And the vector B is, of course, 10 and 4. In fact, we have done this several times in our previous lecture. So these are the matrices A, this is X, and this is B, such that our this system of linear equation can be written as a matrix equation AX equals B. So the system of linear equations can be transformed into the matrix equation by finding out the matrix of coefficient. If you remember, we call this matrix as matrix of coefficient for a given system of linear equation. And we have already learned that we can also write the system of linear equation as vector equation. For example, this system of linear equation can be written in this form, x1 into the vector 2 minus 6 plus x2 into the vector minus 1, 3 plus x3 and the vector 1 minus 2 equals 10, 4. If I name these vectors a1, a2 and a3, then I have a vector equation x1, a1 plus x2 a2 plus a x3 a3 equals b, and I call this vector as b. So this is the vector equation, and the vectors a1, notice that the vectors a1, a2 and a3 are the columns of this matrix, columns of this matrix, matrix coefficient. So we have, for a given system of linear equation, we have the coefficient. By finding the matrix of coefficient, we can write the system of linear equation as matrix equation. This is the matrix equation, and this is the vector equation, which are equivalent forms of the system of linear equation. So we have a result, a theorem, which states that if A is an m into n matrix with columns A1, so on and so forth, An, and if B is in Rm, the matrix equation Ax equals B has the same solution set, because these are the same, representing the same system of linear equation, has the same solution set as the vector equation, this one. And in the previous example, I have shown you that with the given system of linear equation, we can write down the matrix equation as well as the vector equation, which in turn has the solution set of the system of linear equation whose augmented matrix is given by this matrix. And we have seen already in the previous slide for a particular example in which we have three variables and two equations. Existence of the solution: the equation Ax equals B has a solution if and only if, it is very important result, if and only if B is a linear combination of columns of A. What does it mean? It means that B, the vector B, belongs to the span of columns of A, A1, A2, up to so on, An. And this means, what does it mean? It means that this vector equation, that we are able to find out the unknowns x1, x2, up to so on, xn, such that this equation holds. B is in the span, because this is span is just the linear combinations of columns of matrix A. And these are the columns of matrix A, A1, A2, A3. And this side, this is LHS, represents the linear combination. If we are able to find out the solution of this linear combination equals B, this system of linear equation, then of course B is in the span of the columns of matrix A, and it means that our system of linear equation Ax equals B has a solution. Because in the previous theorem, we have learned that the matrix equation Ax equals B is the same as this vector equation. And the left-hand side of this vector equation is the linear combination of columns of the matrix A. So this is very important result. Compute Ax, where A is this one and B equals this one. So it is easy to see that x1 into Ax will be Ax equals x1 into the first column, 1 minus 1, 6, plus x2, the second entry and the second column, 3, 5, minus 2, and the third entry of B, x3, and here we have 4, minus 3, and 8. Here we have x, this is x. So we can calculate easily, this will be 2 of x1 plus 3 of x2 plus 4 of x3 minus x1 plus 5 of x2 minus 3 of x3, 6 of x1 minus 2 of x2 plus 8 of x3. So this is the matrix product of A and x. What should be the order of the vector? Next example is, what should be the order of the vector x if A is given by this one, and we need to compute Ax. Of course, A and x, this matrix multiplication is possible. whenever the columns of A equals to the rows of the vector x. This has matrix has order 3 by 2. So x from which space x should be? X should be from R2 because x should have 2 into 1, and any vector which has 2 entries and 1 column is a vector from space R2. And recall that R2 is a space which we obtain from two perpendicular lines, what we call in calculus or in analysis x-axis and y-axis. We have two perpendicular lines. So this is the R2 space. So the order of the vector x should be 2 into 1. I have written a remark here, row vector rule for computing Ax. If the product Ax is defined, then the ith entry in the Ax is the sum of the products of the corresponding entries from row I of A and from the vector x, as we have seen in this example and in the previous examples. So we have this matrix equation. Use this fact and no row operations to find the scalars C1, C2, and C3 such that this equation holds. We have learned a theorem that the matrix equation Ax equals B has the same solution as the vector equation x1 a1 plus x2 a2 plus so on plus xn an equals b, where a has n columns and order of the a is m into n. We have just learned that result that this matrix equation and this vector equation are same. And in this example, we are given this matrix. We can have this matrix as A. This is our X and this is our B. Okay? So this matrix equation, in fact, is equivalent by using this result, minus 3 into the first column, 4, 5, minus 6, minus 1 into the second column of A, minus 3, minus 2, 2, and plus 2 times of the third column, 1, 5, minus 3, should be equals minus 7, minus 3, and 10. I am writing just this matrix equation. If I recall, call it A, X and B, then I can write this matrix equation into this equivalent vector equation. Now compare these two equations, the equation number 1 and this equation. These are the exactly same, having the same vectors, unless so C1 has been replaced by C1 by minus 3, C2 by minus 1, and C3 by 2. So this is the solution of this vector equation. And we don't need any computation. We just use this fact that the matrix equation is equivalent to the vector equation. And we compare and we just got the values of the C1, C2, and C3 by comparing. We continue with the matrix equation. And next we have this example. Let U is a vector from R3 space and V is a vector from R3 and W. You are given three different vectors. It can be shown that 2 of U minus 3 of V minus W equals 0. You can check that. This is a vector equation and here it's not a real number 0. It's a null vector 0 equals which contains 0, 0, and 0. So bold 0 is always a vector. Bold 0. Okay? It is a vector which consists of all entries of 0. And you can verify this one, this vector equation, that with u and v given as this one, then this vector equation holds. Use this fact to find the values of x1 and x2 such that the equation satisfy this. If you just see this equation, then this is what we call the w. This is exactly the vector w, 5, 1, 1. This is what we call 7, 2, 5. We have named this column as u, and as we have the name of the vector v as 3, 1, 1. So, in fact, what we have to do, we have to find out x1, if I am going to write this matrix equation into the vector equation, then I have this x1 plus x2, 3, 1 and 3 equals 5, 1, 1. So I don't need to solve this system of linear equation. I will use this fact. From this vector equation, I can have 2 of u minus 3 of v equals w. Now this is w, this is v, and this is x2 plus this is u, and here we have x1. Compare these two equations, equation number 1 and equation number 2. So I am having the direct solution x1 equals 2 and x2 equals minus 3. Without solving the system of linear equation, I am having the solution because I have given a linear combination which lead to this matrix equation. And then I write down corresponding to this matrix equation a vector equation, and I have a solution by comparison directly. I don't need to solve this system of linear equation. So this is just the practice problem for the matrix equation and the vector equation for evaluating different unknowns while keeping in mind that the matrix equation and the vector equation in fact represents the same system of linear equation. Let's do the next example, which is the very important example. So let A be a matrix given by this one, and B is another vector which has order 3:1. It means belongs to the space B is from the space R3. And you are asked the question, is the equation Ax equals B consistent for all possible values? So in order to answer that question, we will recall that result or theorem which we have learned in this lecture, that this matrix equation in fact equivalent to this vector equation A1, where A1 is the first column of the matrix, plus A2 into X2, X2 is the unknown, plus X1 is the unknown, X3 is the unknown, A3 equals B. So this matrix equation and this vector equation are equivalent. These two equations are equivalent. And we have already learned that this vector equation and matrix equation are equivalent to the system of linear equation which have the augmented matrix 1, minus 4, minus 3, 3, 2, minus 2, 4, minus 6, minus 7, and the B vector, which is B1, B2, B3. Let me tell you something. Kya cheez main batana chahta hoon ki this V vector, B1, B2, B3 are any real numbers. B1, B2, B3 belongs to real numbers. And we have to find out whether this system of linear equation is consistent or not. If we have B1, B2, B3 belongs to real number, could be any real number, then this vector B is known as the arbitrary element of the space R3. Because I can take different values of B1, B2 and B3, which are from the set of real numbers, to find out any vector in R3. So that is why we call this vector as arbitrary element of R3. So we are going to solve this system. So the first I have to make this 0 and this 0. I will have here 0, 0. I have to add 4 times. So 2 plus 4 times 12, that will become 14. I will have here 14, 4b1, and I have to add 4 times, so that will be here I will have 10b2 plus 4 times b1. Similarly, for making this entry 0, I have to make the row operation R3 plus 3 times R1. That will make here 0. So 3 times R1, the second entry will be minus 2 plus 3 threes are 9. That will be 7. So here I will have 7. And I will have 3 times, which is 12 minus 7 plus. So that will give me 5 plus 5. And here I will have B3 plus 3 times of B1. So next, this is our pivot element. And I have to make this one 0. So what I will do? I will do this row operation. 1 by 2 times R2, and I have to subtract this one from R3. So our matrix will be row equivalent to 1, 0, 0, 3, 4, b1, 14, 10, b2 plus 4, b1 as it is. So 1 by 2 times subtract, this will be 0. 1 by 2 times subtract, this will be 0. And here we will have b3. Plus 3b1 minus 1 by 2 times subtract minus b by 2 minus 2b1. So this is the matrix which is in echelon form. Yeh matrix hamara echelon form mein aa gaya. Ab system hamara consistent hoga. Ye arbitrary element hai, b1, b2 and b3. Isko agar main simplify kar lun, that will become b3 plus b1 minus b2 divided by 2. Simplify kar liya. Plus 3b1 minus 2b1 results to the plus b1. So this is my this entry. अब हमने ये पढ़ा हुआ है कि अगर हमारा एचिलॉन फॉर्म में ऑगमेंटेड मैट्रिक्स का राइट मोस्ट कॉलम जो है वो इस फॉर्म में हो 0, 0 इंट बी वेयर बी इज नॉट इक्वल टू 0, देन आवर सिस्टम ऑफ लीनियर इक्वेशन इज इनकंसिस्टेंट. सो दिस सिस्टम विल बी इनकंसिस्टेंट इफ दिस नंबर which is b3 plus b1 minus b2 divided by 2 is not equal to 0, because we will have an equation corresponding to third row as 0 equals some non-zero number, which is not true. So the system of linear equation will be inconsistent. And the system will be consistent if we have b3 plus b1 minus b2 over 2 equals 0. So this is the relationship correspond to the consistent system AX equals B, and this is the relation correspond to the inconsistent system with the matrix this one, with the matrix this one, and with this vector, and this is an arbitrary vector of R3. So we have found a relationship which will tell us that if this relationship satisfy by the B1, B2 and B3, then the system will be consistent. Okay, let's go to the next slide. In the next slide, we have very, very important result. In fact, there are four different statements which are equivalent statements, logically equivalent statements. Logically equivalent statements are those statements which are true. If one of them statement is true, then all will be true. If one of them is false, then all statements which are logically equivalent will be false. So the logical statements kya hoti hain? Logical statements, wo statements hoti hain, jin mein, which has the same truth values. Truth values kya hoti hain? Whether the statement, given statement is false or true. Agar logical statement, let's say aapke paas 10 logical statements hain, and we say that these 10 logical statements are equivalent. Iska matlab ye hoga ki agar ek bhi logical statement jo hai wo true hai to baki 9 ki 9 bhi true hongi. Agar ek bhi unme se false hoti hai to baki bhi 9 ki 9 kya hongi? False hongi. So all the logically equivalent statements always have the same truth values, whether they will be true. If they are true, all will be true. If one of them is false, then all will be false. So we will have a very important result about the solution of the system of linear equations, which give us logically equivalent statements. Let's go to the slide and see. Let A be an M into N matrix. A jo hai M into N matrix hai hamara. Then the following statements are logically equivalent. It means logically equivalent statements मैंने आपको समझा दी हैं कि तमाम की तमाम true होंगी अगर एक भी true हो, तमाम की तमाम false होंगी. इस तरह नहीं हो सकता कि एक statement जो है वो true हो दूसरी statement false हो. अगर इस तरह का case हो तो हम कहते हैं कि ये statements logically equivalent नहीं है. Logically equivalent statements वो statements होती हैं which have the same truth values, all are the same, true or false. That is, for a particular matrix A, either they all true statements or they all are false statements. For each B in Rm, the equation Ax equals B has a solution. Now, has a solution mean that unique solution and infinite many solution. And we already know that, we have learned that a system of linear equation which has a solution, unique or infinite many, we call that system consistent. Then this statement is logically equivalent to the each B in Rm is a linear combination of columns of A. Of course, yes, we have seen in the previous examples. Then the third statement, the columns of A span Rm. Of course, this will also true. Ye bhi true hoga. So all these three statements are equivalent. And the third, fourth statement is A has a pivot position in every row. So all the four statements are logically equivalent, means if we have the solution of this system, unique or infinite many, then each B is the linear combination of columns of A. What does it mean? It means that the columns of A in fact span Rm. If each B, what does it mean? Each B is a linear combination of columns of A. If I denote, it means that I am able to find out C1, A1, the constant C1, C2, such that this system has a solution, Cn, An, where A1, A2, and An are the columns of the matrix A. So this, if this holds, this is equivalent to this matrix equation. If this matrix equation has a solution, then I can write every B, because this matrix equation has the solution for each B. It means I am able to find out the constant C1, C2 and Cn. So it means that arbitrary element of Rm, which is B, can be written as linear combination of columns of A, which exactly says this second statement. Now we know that the set of all linear combinations of given vectors, we call it span. So the columns of A span Rm, because B was the arbitrary element of Rm. As in the previous case, we take B as B1, B2, B3 in the space R3, That was the arbitrary element. And here B is the arbitrary element, each element. Each element means each and every element. And if we have to take this one, we will take B equals B1, B2, so on and so forth, up to so on, Bm, where Bi, I from 1 to m are the real numbers. A has a pivot position. Of course, A has a pivot position if the system of linear equations has a solution. The above theorem, this is the very important remark. The above theorem is about the coefficient matrix. We know that in this system of linear equation, which is written in the matrix form, the A is the matrix of coefficient, not an augmented matrix. Be careful. This result that A has pivot position in every row and A is the matrix of coefficient of the system of linear equation, not the augmented matrix. If augmented matrix has pivot position in every row, then we have the both possibility. Then the solution may or may not exist. We may have the solution, we may not have the solution. For example, the previous theorem, I can write such a matrix, augmented matrix of a system of linear equation 3, 1, let's say 0, 0, let's say 4, 5, 0, and 0, 0, 7. This is the augmented matrix of some system of linear equation. Now the augmented matrix has pivot position in every row, but we know that the system of linear equation corresponding to this augmented matrix is inconsistent. So the previous result was true for the matrix of coefficient. And similarly, we can have, so this is the one example in which we have the augmented matrix and the system is inconsistent. And we can have another example, 1, 2, 3, 1, which has the pivot position in every row and has a solution, let's say 7 and here 8. So this is the augmented matrix corresponding to a system of linear equation which is consistent. So the in the previous theorem, this that A has a pivot position and all these statements are equivalent, we cannot say the same for the augmented matrix. This remark, this is very very important remarks, and mostly students jo hai mistake karte hain by taking this remark. So next result is about the some properties of the system of matrix equation. If A is an m into n matrix, U and V are vectors in Rn, because A ka order m into n hai, तो वेक्टर्स आर एन से ही होंगे, क्योंकि हम चाहते हैं कि ये मैट्रिक्स प्रोडक्ट ए एक्स जो है ये प्रोडक्ट पॉसिबल हो. सो एम इनटू एन ऑर्डर, वंस अगेन आई एम टू टेल यू दैट नंबर ऑफ कॉलम्स ऑफ द फर्स्ट मैट्रिक्स इन द मैट्रिक्स प्रोडक्ट शुड बी इक्वल टू द नंबर ऑफ कॉलम्स, नंबर ऑफ रोज ऑफ द सेकेंड मैट्रिक्स. सो द एक्स शुड हैव द ऑर्डर एन इंटू वन. सो एन इंटू वन वैक्टर जो होता है, ये हमने नाम रखा हुआ है कि आर एन स्पेस में होगा. दैट्स वाई दीज वैक्टर्स U and V are always from the space Rn. ठीक है? And C is any scalar. C is any scalar, then these are the two properties which we can verify by taking some particular matrix and some vectors from Rn, such that the matrix product A, U plus V, whether you take these two vectors from Rn, you add them and then take the matrix multiplication with the matrix A of the resulting of the addition of U and V, or equals, this is the same as the matrix A multiplied by U and matrix A multiplied by V, and then we do the addition of these two matrices. So the result will be same. The second property is that if we have a matrix A and a scalar C, whether you multiply the scalar with the vector U and then multiply the resulting vector CU with the matrix A, or you Calculate the matrix product A and U and then multiply with the scalar C. Let's do with some examples. Let's say A, our A is of order 2 by 2, 1, 1 and 5. And then our R, X or U and V will be from R2 because this has order 2 by 2. Let's say U equals 1, 1 and V equals 5, 7. So what is the first property? First property says that whether you do calculate U plus V 1, 1 plus 5, 7, whether you do this one, that will be the answer 6 and 8. And then you multiply with the matrix U plus V. This resulting matrix of U plus V. 1, 1, 2, 5, and the result here 6 and 8. So the answer of this one will be 6 plus 16 and 6 plus 40. So this turns out to be 22 and 46. So this is one equation. We have calculated the left hand side. Similarly, you can calculate the A of U. That will be A, my matrix A, 1, 1, 2, 5, this is 1, multiplied by my matrix U is 1 and 1. So the answer is 1 plus 2, 1 plus 5, the answer is 3 and 6. And you calculate AV, which is 1, 1, 2, 5, and my vector V is 5, 7. And the answer of this one is 5 plus 14 and 5 plus 7, 5 are 35. It turns out 19 and 40. So the right hand side of this equation is A of U plus A of V. So we will have 3, 6 plus 19 and 40. So this turns out to be 22 and 46. Exactly the same as we have the LHS. So this is the first example I have done for you, this property. Similarly, you can do for this one. In fact, we can prove these property for any U and V from Rm and for any matrix A, M into N. So this is very important example which we are going to start now. This example states that let U be this vector, V be this vector and W be this vector. Does U, V, W span R3? These vectors are from R3 and we know that if the vectors are from a certain space, then the span of these vectors is the subset of the space from where these vectors are. And these vectors for this particular example are from R3. U1, U, V and W vectors jo hain R3 space mein se hai na, to inka linear combination bhi R3 mein se hoga. To span set of all linear combination hota hai. To set of all linear combination mein element jo honge wo R3 ke element honge. R3 aapka bada set hai, to span ek subset hoga. So this is the first equation we always have. The question asked from us is, does U, V, W span R3? It means that is this span of U, V and W equals R3? Span subset to hota hai R3 ka. Ab equal R3 kab hoga? Jab main, aapko pata hai ki ए और बी दो वेक्टर्स हो, सॉरी ए और बी आर टू सेट्स, देन ए इक्वल्स बी इफ एंड ओनली इफ, इफ एंड ओनली इफ आई हैव टू शो दैट ए इज सबसेट ऑफ बी, विच मीन्स दैट एवरी एलिमेंट ऑफ ए बिलोंग्स टू बी. I have to show this one static and B subset of A, and I have to show this one double static. If I am able to show that A subset of B and B subset of A, this implies that the set A and B are equal. So the sets A and B are equal if and only if A subset of B and B subset of A. Every element of A, what does it mean? A subset of B, every element of A also belongs to the set B. Every element of B, what does it mean? B subset of A, every element of B also belongs to A. It means both A and B have the same elements. So A equals B. So span ke liye humare paas ye equation number 1 jo hoti hai, span of a given vectors is always a subset of the space from where these vectors are. For example, these vectors are from space R3, so span of U, V and W is subset of R3. In order to check that whether span of U, V, W equals R3, I have to show that, I have to check whether that R3 is subset of span of U, V and W. And combining these two equations, if this is true, the equation 2 is true, then I will be able to say that this equation holds, which means the vectors U, V and W span R3. Now, I have to show this, that R3 is a subset of span of U, V. In fact, I have to check that whether this is true or not. Yes, true hai ke nahi. Uske liye main kya karunga? Main koi bhi arbitrary element R3 ka jo hai, wo le leta hun. B vector belongs to R3. Ab B vector kis tarah ka hai? Agar ye arbitrary element hai, so I cannot take particular values of from R3, let's say 1, 1, 1. Is tarah nahi main le sakta. If B is arbitrary vector, then I will suppose that B equals B1, B2 and B3. Where B1, B2 and B3 belongs to real number. So this is called an arbitrary element of space R3. Because I have not taken a particular element. And I have done this in the last example, which I have taken an arbitrary element. So, I have to check whether this arbitrary element of B, arbitrary but general element of R3, which is B, can be written as linear combination of U, V and W. It means I have to solve this vector equation. C1 U plus C2 V plus C3 W equals B. And we have learned a result that this vector equation and the matrix equation AX equals B has the same solution as the system of linear equation with these columns, where A is found by the first column of A matrix found by the vector U, the second column of matrix A is found by the vector V, so on and so forth, third column is formed by the vector W. So the augmented matrix of this vector equation or this matrix equation is 0, 0, minus 3, 0, minus 3, 9, 4, minus 2, minus 6 and B, the vector B, which is B1, B2 and B3. So this is the augmented matrix of the system of linear equation, and we are looking for the solution of the system of linear equation whose vector equation is given by this one, whose matrix equation is given by this one. So the first operation which I will do, I will interchange the row. Minus 3, 9, minus 6, and B3. And second row as it is, minus 3, minus 2, and B2. And the third row will become the first row, which was previously the first row. So this is the first, I interchange. Now I see minus 3 here, 9 here, and minus 6 here. And by doing this row operation, my augmented matrix is in echelon form. This is the pivot and all entries are 0. This is the pivot, all entries below are 0. This is the pivot and there is no entry below this one. So if I write down the solution of this one, this will give me four, the equivalence corresponding to this augmented matrix is 4C3 equals B1. From here I have C3 equals B1 over 4. The second row give me minus 3C2, minus 2C3 equals B2. And we have C2 equals 2 times minus or minus B2 plus 2 times C3 over minus 3. Okay, this is the expression of C2. And of course, in this expression, we can put the value of C3 and have the value of C2. Similarly, from the first equation, we have C1. C1 equals minus 9 times C2 plus 6 times C3 plus B3 divided by minus 3. And of course, we can put C3 and C2 in this expression and get the value of C1. So whatever the values of B1, B2, B3 is, our system is always consistent. It means that we have a solution of this system, and solution is given by these three, C1, C2, and C3, these three expressions. It means that we took arbitrary element of R3, and we are able to show that this element can be written as a linear combination of the vectors U, V, and W. So our every vector, arbitrary vector of R3 is in the span of U, V, and W. In other words, we have proved that R3, every element of R3, B belongs to R3 implies B belongs to span of U, V, and W. And this, what does it mean? It means R3 is a subset of span of U, V, and W. So this is exactly what we want. We want to check that whether equation 2 holds or not. And we have seen that equation 2 holds. Why? The solution of the system exists. And combining 1 and 2, we have this equation which says that these vectors U, V, and W, the span of U, V, and W in fact equals R3. Now, if you check that the matrix of coefficient is this one, and if we don't want to do this calculation, we can use the previous theorem which we have learned in this lecture. The matrix of coefficient has pivot element in every row. So the system AX equals B is consistent. And this system which written here also is equivalent to this one. Vector equation also have the solution. So we can also use the result, and we can also have the explicit values of C1, C2, and C3 such that the solution of this system of linear equation holds, and ultimately we have proved that the span of these three vectors u, v and w in fact equals R3, and such type of questions are very important questions. Similarly, I can give you the four vectors from R4, and I can ask a question whether these four vectors span the R4 or so on and so forth. We are almost at the end of our lecture, and as you know that at the end of each lecture I give you some practice problems. So here are your practice problems. Let me give you some hint of the practice problem for the solution of the practice problem. The first question is, let u, v and w are the vectors from which space? R4, because these are having the entries, four entries, all these vectors having the four entries. So these are from R4, u, v and w. This is also belongs to R4. This is also belongs to R4. Now I ask the question, does span of u, v, w equals R? This is the same thing of asking, does u, v, w span R4 or span of u, v, w equals R4? You will do exactly the same way as we do in the previous example. Justify your answer, and you have to give the justification of your answer. The columns of the matrix, the B part is, the columns of the matrix span R4. Are the columns, I am asking, are the columns of the matrix span R4? So you consider these columns of the matrix as vectors and check whether span of these columns, let's say this is A1, this is A2, this is A3, this is A4, and all these vectors A1, A2 corresponding to these columns are from R4. Whether the span of these columns equals R4, you will do exactly the same as you have done in part A and as we have done in the previous example in this lecture. Question number third is, suppose A is a 4x4 matrix and B is a vector in R4 with the property that AX equals B has a unique solution. Explain why the columns of A must span. You have to use the theorem which we have learned in this lecture. Rewrite the numerical matrix equation below in symbolic form as a vector equation. This is a matrix equation. You have to write down this matrix equation as a vector equation, and we have learned this in this lecture as well as in the previous lecture number 3. So this is the end of our lecture number 4. Inshallah, I will see you in the next lecture. Allah Hafiz.